What astrology is to astronomy, what alchemy is to chemistry, so superstition is to scientific innovation. You have to stumble your way into facthood. And yet John Trapp, about 400 years ago, argues that God remains the great alchemist. He can magically transmogrify dross into gold through fire. He can magically extrapolate beauty from ashes. He can magically turn mourning into dancing. He is the great alchemist. And that's what 1 Peter 1:7 says, that your fire that you're going through, the fire of affliction, is actually creating a faith in you that is more precious than gold. So the fire actually turns the dross into something golden, and so that it results in the praise and honor and glory of God, meaning God can fetch honor out of our misery. God can curate and create and cultivate medicinal sicknesses. God can magically make golden afflictions, because he is in fact and in sooth the great alchemist. He can fetch honor out of the depths, and he can tease out wine from viper's venom. Psalm 46 verse 1 says God is a very present help in time of trouble. So like Marcus Aurelius wrote in Meditations, whether the ash falls from the altar now or later, it makes no difference. We do not have to be complaining, and we don't have to be whining, and we don't have to be Gonzimon, murmuring Meribah like the children of Israel. We can instead realize that there is a great alchemist in heaven who causes us to never lose heart and never lose hope, because he fetches honor out of the depths. He teases out wine from viper's venom. He makes golden afflictions. He makes medicinal sicknesses, so we can be absolutely confident that the worst things that we go through, he extrapolates from them the best blessings of our life, so we are not going to lose heart and we are not going to lose hope.